Hi, mein Name ist Steffen Fürst. I'm a researcher at Freie Universität Berlin and SUSE Institute Berlin and want to present my work on Mahana, which is an agent-based modeling framework that supports large-scale simulations. Here is an overview of the next 25 minutes. I will begin with a brief introduction to agent-based models and the motivation for a new framework, although many already exist. Following this, I will explain the mathematical foundations underpinning Vahana and demonstrate how to implement a simple model. Then I will scratch some implementation details of Vahana and show how Julia's metaprogramming capabilities are used to produce optimized code. And by means of simulation runs of two different models, I will show that this indeed leads to performant results. Afterwards, I discuss how Vahana can handle spatial information via discrete rasters. And before I end with a summary, I'll explain how Vahana interacts with various Julia packages. Agent-based modeling, or ABM for short, is a simulation technique where we create a system of individual components, so-called agents that interact with each other. Those agents have rules that define their behavior at the microscale level. When these behaviors interact over time, they often give rise to emergent phenomena on the macroscale level. A unique feature of ABMs is the ability to represent complex network interactions between agents. But ABMs come with a computational cost. Calculating all the individual actions can make those models computationally expensive, especially when dealing with large systems. Therefore, efficient computational strategies and tools are essential for the practical application of large-scale ABMs. Given that the agents usually operate only on local information, without full knowledge of the entire system, there's an underlying potential for an effective parallel execution of a simulation. There exists already many ABM frameworks. The COMSIS webpage. COMSIS is a network for computational modeling in social and ecological science, lists about 50 different modeling frameworks alone. The most prominent framework written in Julia is AgentJL, which was already presented at the JuliaCon 2 years ago. However, as already mentioned, for large-scale models that, for example, simulating entire populations of a country, the computational demands are really high. The ability to parallelize a simulation can provide a significant advantage, and it's sometimes really necessary. Unfortunately, only a few of these frameworks support parallelization. They often come with a steep learning curve, and a limited set of features, especially when it comes to the support of complex networks. Therefore, during a project we have done a few years ago, we recognized the need of a new HPC-capable ABM framework. This led to the conception of the framework that we now call Vahana. Over the last year and a half, I have been working intensively on the implementation. Vahana has a focus on network-based models. It does provide support for spatial simulations in discrete spaces, but this is not its primary strength. What sets Vahana truly apart from its HPC counterparts is how it simplifies the development phase. Vahana unburdens the model developers of the usual problems and challenges that come with the parallel execution of programs. However, this requires that the model are formulated as a graph dynamical system, which imposes certain constraints. A graph dynamical system, GDS for short, is a graph where each vertex has a state. There's a vertex function that updates the state of a vertex only based on states of its neighboring vertices. We are interested in synchronous graph dynamical systems, where all vertex state updates happen simultaneously. This can be also seen as a generalized cellular automata. The difference is the neighborhood relationship. In a cellular automata, the neighbors are defined via the position of the cells on the grid, so we have a spatial neighborhood. In a GDS, the neighborhood of a vertex is given by the incoming edges of the graph. We extend this concept of graph dynamical systems by allowing different types of vertices and edges. In Julia, these types are implemented as composite bits types, which means that the state variables can be numbers or bools, but nothing that points to other objects like vectors. We can interpret the vertices as agents and the state variables of agent and edges as labels of the graph. So we have a directed labeled multigraph. We are also permitting loops, which are edges that are going from an agent to itself. In the following, I will illustrate such a graph with an extremely simple economic model. In this model, we have two types of agents, sellers and buyers. Two different goods are created, and for each good, the sellers have a different price, P1 and P2. The buyers have limited knowledge and don't know the prices of all the sellers. This relationship is expressed in the model by the edge type nose. We will need also additional edges of type buy, which will signal the amounts of goods a buyer wants to obtain from a seller. When we want to implement this in Mahana, we first must define all types used. For the sellers, we create a struct with two fields for the different prices. The buyers are in our extreme simple model without any state, and also the no edges do not need any state. The buy edges that have the quantity of the bought goods as fields. The first step we take in Mahana is to inform it about all the agent and edge types we will use in our model. We accomplish this by using the model types constructor to generate a starting point. Then we add to our model types instance each type of agent and edge. Finally, we create our model and give it a name, like simple example in this case. As you can see, Mahana display a warning. We ignore this for now, but at the end of the presentation, you can hopefully understand the message. We now create a simulation. A simulation is a concrete realization of a model, including simulation parameters and global, graph-independent values, which often are used to retrieve aggregated simulation results. However, for our current example, we will ignore these additional elements and set them to nothing. We can add now to our simulation instance the sellers and buyers by calling the addAgents function. This function returns IDs for these agents, which we can then use in the following steps to create the edges between the agents. As the final step, we must invoke the finishInit function. In the case that the simulation is run in parallel, this function partitions the graph and distributes it among the individual processes. Consequently, from this moment forward, each process only is aware of the subgraph of the original graph. So far we have created an initial state, but we also need a method to change this state. We do this with so-called transition functions. These transition functions are mappings that take the state of an agent and the state of the neighborhood of this agent for a subgraph spanned by a subset of the edge types. In this context, the neighborhood includes all agents located at the source of the edges leading to the agent in question. If this agent itself possesses state, the state can also be considered in the transition function. The result of the transition function is a set of agents, often only the called agent with a modified state, and a set of edges. Both can be empty sets, and edges can be only added between agents in the neighborhood and the agent in question. By taking the union of all returned sets, Mahana constructs a new graph. In the initial prototype, this principle was consequently executed and even the invariant parts of the graph had to be reconstructed by the agents. However, in the current version, when a transition function is called, the types of agents and edges whose state may change must be explicitly specified. We now create a transition function for our simple model. In this function, every buyer agent will purchase a unit of each good from the seller agent who offers this good at the lowest price. A transition function always takes three arguments. The first is the state of the agent making decisions within the transition function. The second is the ID of the agent, and the third is the simulation itself. To calculate the demand, each buyer must fetch the prices established by the sellers. First, we call the function neighborIDs to get the IDs of all agents connected to the current edges of type nose. With these IDs, the agent can then query the state and thus the prices of the sellers. The buyer can now identify the seller offering the lowest price for each good and create an edge of type buy from himself to the seller. So once we have defined our transition functions, the next step is to apply it to our simulation using Mahana's apply function. I hope the first two arguments are self-explanatory. The third argument specifies the types of agents that the function should be applied to. The fourth argument tells the simulation what types of data our transition function needs to access. As in Mahana, information such as new ages or the current state of agents is not automatically transmitted between different processes. The last argument lets Mahana know what can potentially be changed by the function. For example, since buyer is not listed in the read argument, Mahana understands that the transition function doesn't return a new state for the agent. When a transition function attempts to read or write a state that isn't specified in the corresponding arguments, by default it will trigger an assertion. However, these checks can be disabled after the development phase to improve the performance. We can utilize the REPL to examine the state of the simulation. As already seen, the show function of a simulation provides an overview of the current state, including the numbers of agents and ages per type. Given the extensive use of H's in a Vahana model, a simple check of the number of these H's can quickly reveal if something is not working as expected. It's also possible to inspect the simulation from the perspective of an individual agent. In this case, the specific part of a graph that the agent can access within a transition function is displayed. As we saw in the example, H's in Vahana not only determines the visible state of an agent, but have other use cases as well. They can be used to send messages, as we have done this with the H's of type by. Furthermore, when an agent responds to a received H by sending an H back, this mimics the mechanism of function calls, with the difference that the response can take into account all requests. They can be also used to mimic vectors. As mentioned at the beginning, the agent state must have a fixed size, but since an agent can create any number of H's pointing to itself, an agent can extend the state space in a flexible way. And H's can also be used to gather information useful for post-processing the simulations. Let's now shift our focus to some implementation details of Vahana. In Vahana, the specific code for accessing and managing the state of the model is generated dynamically during the create model function call. This code generation process can be influenced by so-called hints to improve performance. Let's look at one example to understand this better, namely the edge hints. The edge hints are additional properties of an edge type which can be set by optional arguments of the function register edge type. For instance, when we provide the ignore from hint, Vahana does not store the ID of the source vertex. On the other hand, if we add the stateless hint, then Vahana keeps only the ID of the source vertex. If we add both, only the number of edges are counted. The single type hint tells Vahana that all source vertices have the same type, and the single edge hint indicates that each agent is the target of just one edge of a particular type. The hints influence which functions are created at all. For example, for an edge type with the hint ignore from, create model will not create a neighbor IDs function. As you can expect, all these hints also influence the data structure used for the adjacency matrix. Here are a few examples of all possible combinations. If no hint is given, they are stored in a dictionary, the keys are the IDs of the target vertex, and the values are the vector of edges going to the destination vertex. Here the edge struct has two fields, namely the ID of the source vertex and the state of the edge. When the stateless hint is given, only the IDs of the source vertexes are stored accordingly. The single type hint is a bit more complicated and has to do with Vahana's internal use of agent IDs. Among other things, these contain the agent type as information. If this does not need to be stored because the type can be reconstructed via the hints, a vector of vectors is sufficient to store the adjacency matrix. With all four hints in place, the logical combination leads to the point where we only need a single Boolean vector. Of course, all functions that are working on these data structures must be generated accordingly. You see here is an example, the addH function. The first version is a generated code for the default case without any hints, and the second one is a version with all four hints. As you can see, in this case, the only overhead Vahana has compared to an implementation that works directly with a Boolean vector is the AND operator to retrieve the vector index from the agent ID. Let's now move on to a practical example that helps us to evaluate the performance benefits of using hints. We will use the well-known Hexemann-Krause-Opinion model for this analysis. The Hexemann-Krause model is a mathematical model for opinion dynamics, simulating how individual opinions within a group evolve over time based on social influence. Typically, all agents are connected, forming a complete graph, but in the following, we want to understand how different graph structures can impact both performance and scalability. Therefore, we consider two additional graph structures, namely regular graphs, where each vertex has the same number of edges, and clique graphs, which consists of numerous equal-sized cliques, where only a single vertex from each clique is connected to the neighboring cliques. Let's now turn to our first figure, a bar chart representing the performance differences when hints were enabled. For this example, we create full graphs that consist of 10,000 vertices. The regular graph has 1 million vertices with 10 neighbors each, and the clique graph has 100,000 cliques with 10 vertices each. The times given in this diagram represents the duration of a single iteration. Also, results presented here were derived from simulation once performed on the LISA cluster at the SUSE Institute Berlin. Each node of this cluster is equipped with two Intel Cascade Lake Platinum 9242 processors, each with 48 cores, and each node has 384 GB of memory. The bar chart clearly indicates that the benefits of using hints varies dependently on the graph structure. For the complete graph, the performance improvement is less pronounced than for the other two structures. This difference can be explained by the fact that in the complete graph scenario, the agent state function calls make up a significant proportion of the total calls. These calls don't benefit as much from the hints as the neighbor IDs function calls do. Before we move on to scalability, let's first examine the single-threaded performance of Vahana. The best scalability doesn't help when the base performance is lacking. To check this, we will compare results from the complete graph case with a straightforward Julia implementation and an existing one in HNSJL. As we can observe, Vahana performs well when compared to HNSJL, but falls short against the direct Julia-only implementation. The Julia-only version excels because it takes full advantage of the complete graph structure by accessing the opinion array directly without any filter. However, this implementation cannot support other graph structures. When we adjust this implementation by including the GraphJL package to deal with regular and click graphs, the gap in performance almost vanishes. So, it seems we have a solid serial performance. Now let us look at the performance of the parallel executions. As we can see, the model scales quite well for all graph types, as long as we restrict ourselves to using a single node. However, when we distribute the simulation across multiple nodes, the performance heavily depends on the graph structure. This is primarily due to the fact that an agent state function call becomes quite expensive when it needs to access an agent living on a different node. In the HK model, a significant proportion of the operations involves these agent state function calls. Next, we take a look at an existing large-scale model, namely MatSim-EpiSim, an epidemiological model that is very computational intensive and can benefit significantly from a framework like Vahana. MatSim-EpiSim is designed to simulate the spread of infectious diseases among individuals. In this model, agents navigate between different locations, such as their homes, workplaces, or schools, following daily routines based on mobile cell data. Each location records arrival and departure times of the agents. Based on this data, the likelihood of each agent getting infected is calculated. In a previous project, I worked on the multi-threaded parallelization of this model, which is written in Java. Now, I recreated also an early version of MatSim-EpiSim using Vahana. Two different scenarios were used to evaluate the scalability. The first scenario represents the Berlin area, featuring around 1 million agents that are standing for the 4 million persons living in Berlin. There are also nearly 1 million locations. In the course of a single simulated day, without any policy interventions, these agents change the locations about 7 million times. The second scenario represents the whole of Germany. Here, about 16 million agents are used to represent the population. There are about 12 million locations, and in the course of a single simulated day, the agents change location about 90 million times. All the runtimes shown in the following figures are for the simulation of 365 days. Unsurprisingly, the scalability depends on the size of the problem. Unlike in the HK model, scaling across multiple nodes doesn't pose an issue this time. This is due to the fact that when an agent visits a location, it creates an edge targeted to that location that contains all necessary information, such as the agent's current health status. The result is that we can speed up the Germany scenario by a factor of 207 when we use 8 compute nodes. I want also to disclose that a single-threaded run of the Vahana implementation is approximately 30% slower than the original Java version. Nevertheless, when we compare the fastest parallel simulation of the Java version, restricted to one node due to its thread-based parallelization, is the Vahana simulation across 8 nodes, we archive the speedup by a factor of 29. Even when Vahana is also limited to one node, it outperforms the Java version by a factor of 7. Also, it must be stated that the features implemented in each version are not identical. But the features that we found to be the most critical to performance during the parallelization of MatSim-EpiSim, such as contact tracing, are included in both implementations. We are now turning to additional features of Vahana. As mentioned at the beginning, Vahana also supports simulations with a spatial dimension, although this is not its strength, at least when the agents move a lot in space. In the following, I will demonstrate how Vahana does this. The interesting thing here is how the spatial aspect is integrated into the graph. The first step is always to call the addRaster function. This function generates a raster with an agent for each cell. One argument of the function is itself a function that gets the Cartesian index of the cell and must return an agent. We have two strategies to utilize the raster cells, which can be also combined. The first one is to connect the cells of a raster. This can be done with a function called connectRasterNeighbors, which, in addition to a distance argument, also supports various metrics. With this, we can easily create cellular automata. The second strategy creates edges between agents of a different type and the cells, which can be achieved using the MoveTo function. In its current version, Vahana doesn't include a function that enables finding agents that are connected to cells in the surrounding area of a specific cell. But nevertheless, this functionality can still be realized using the current features of Vahana. Like the connectRasterNeighbors function, MoveTo can also consider the neighborhood of a cell. So we can use the MoveTo function again to create edges of type position neighborhood that lead to the raster neighborhood of the agent's position. In the second step, the cells can now check if there are agents connected with them via agents of type position, and if there are also other agents in the neighborhood via the agents of the type position neighborhood. If this is the case, they can create agents between them, so that afterwards each agent knows the other agents in the neighborhood of this specific raster and metric. Included in the examples in the Vahana documentation is a predator prey model that demonstrates this functionality in detail. Finally, I would like to give an overview of how Vahana interacts with the Julia ecosystem. The simulations are parallelized using the MPI JL package, which is a Julia interface with a message parsing interface standard widely used for distributed computing. The user of Vahana will only notice this because they have to start a parallel simulation using MPI 1. The HDF5 packages is used to save the state of a simulation. HDF5 is a high-performance data management system that is designed for storing large, complex datasets. Vahana supports parallel HDF5, including collective writes, as long as the used HDF5 library supports it as well. A simulation can be later read into a REPL session. The graph originally distributed across different processes will then be merged into a single graph. The same methods can be employed for checkpointing a simulation or preparing an initial pre-processed distributed state of a simulation. Tomorrow, there will be also a dedicated talk about HDF5 at the JuliaCon. The instances of each agent and edge type can be converted to a data frame. This functionality is useful for pre- or post-processing a simulation, but it should not be used within a simulation itself. As you may have guessed from the Hexemann-Krause example, Vahana also provides an interface to GraphsJL, similar to rasters. Graphs created with GraphsJL can be included to a Vahana graph. In addition, Vahana supports the abstract graph interface, so you can apply the functionality of GraphsJL to it. Thanks to the abstract graph interface, GraphMaker can be used for visualization of Vahana graph without additional contribution from Vahana. However, Vahana also comes with additional functions that utilize the interactive interface of GraphMaker to generate interactive Vahana graphs. Here is shown an example of a model where the agents are living on a 6x6 raster. The createGraphBuild function takes optional callback functions as arguments. These functions are called for each agent at age and can set the properties for that element. Also, createGraphBuild can optionally jitter the position of the agents to avoid overlaps. As we approach the end of this presentation, let's recap the central points. Vahana is a new simulation framework designed to empower the parallel execution of agent-based models. It extends the concept of graph dynamical systems and places a strong focus on the support of complex networks, but also supports spatial simulations by integration rasters into the graph. Despite being optimized for parallel execution, the user-friendly interface makes it interesting also for small simulations. The practicality of Vahana is demonstrated through a re-implementation of the EpiSim model, which showcases a dramatic speed-up compared to the original implementation. I hope I've managed to spark your interest in Vahana. Thank you all for your attention, and I look forward to answering any questions you may have.